Mr. President, I rise today to talk about a vote that we'll take in the Senate sometime later today after 12 o'clock. It'll be a cloture vote on the VA Mission Act, which after we adopt cloture later this week, hopefully will lead us to the final vote to adopt the VA Mission Act, which will be the final mosaic in a picture that's been together by the Senate Veterans Affairs Committee, the House Veterans Affairs Committee, the administration, and both the House and Senate to address the VA benefits program for all our veterans. We all know we've had the challenge to do better. And this, I submit to you, Mr. President, is us doing our very best for those who've given everything for us. You know, on Monday of next week, we celebrate Memorial Day, where we honor those who've sacrificed their life so that we could all be here today. You, Mr. President, as the presiding officer of this body, me as a representative of the people of Georgia. If it wasn't for our veterans, we might be speaking Japanese or German today. We're speaking English today because we won those wars, because our best and our brightest volunteered their lives and sacrificed so that America could survive and be there. There is nothing less that we need to ask of ourselves than to see to it they have the health care benefits we've promised them for so long. The VA Mission Act is an act that puts together and answers all those questions that have been longing on the front pages of the newspapers for the last 2 or 3 years. I want to thank John McCain. John McCain was really the inspiration for the Veterans Choice Bill, which we started 4 years ago when I was on the committee. Finally passed a part of that program, and it's been in operation till now. But it has had some need for reform, need to be fixed, need to be funded, and with the passage of this legislation, we'll do all those things, and we'll make it even better. I want to thank John Tester, the senator from Montana, my ranking member on the committee, who's done everything one could ask to be a team player to see to it we got through all the minefields and sticky wickets that you have to go through in the legislative process to get there. Senator Tester has been an invaluable partner in the VA Mission Act and in making the VA a better organization. Obviously, I want to thank my staff and his staff and my members of the committee from the Republican Party and his members from the Democratic Party. It's as close to a unanimous effort as any effort we've done in the committee for some time. Thank you for their hard work and their effort, and thank you in advance to the members of the House and Senate for being with us on this venture today. I ask for your vote for cloture, and later in the week we'll ask for your vote for final passage. Briefly, let me tell you what we're doing, because what we're doing is critical. One, we're making choice better for our veterans. We're repealing the 30-mile rule, the 40-mile rule, and the 30-day rule, which we passed 4 years ago. People will remember veterans were waiting, in some cases, years to get their appointments at the VA. So we passed a rule that said you can go to the private sector if you can't get an appointment within 30 days, or if you live more than 40 miles away from a VA center that provides that service. But it became cumbersome, difficult. The third-party contractors that we dealt with to make the clearances and open the gates for these veterans to go, we had a number of problems with them. And although we improved service and access for our veterans, we didn't make it everything it should be. The Mission Act does that because it makes the choice the veteran's choice in concert with the veteran's primary care doctor at the VA. If a veteran, because of quality, timeliness, distance, urgency, or need, needs to go to the private sector or wants to exercise that choice rather than go to a VA doctor if there is one, or if there isn't one, go to a private sector because that's the only choice they have, they'll be able to do so in concert with their VA primary care doctor. So choice is truly the veteran's choice. The VA continues the responsibility of keeping up with the veteran. The veteran has the choice he needs to make or she needs to make to see to it they get timely, professional, quality care. That is a huge step forward for us. It's a great step forward. And all of the 30-day rule and the 40-mile rule were great starts. This is a great improvement on access for our veterans. You know, I'm a Vietnam-era veteran. Vietnam-era veterans are now mostly in their late 60s, early or mid-70s. They served our country a long time ago. The signature injuries of the Vietnam War were some of the most tragic in warfare that were survived for the first time ever because of our health care. We have a lot of those veterans living today that can't take care of the basic functions of life. They need assistance in eating, assistance in making their bed, assistance in getting up and down stairs, assistance in getting anywhere they need to go. And we've got veterans programs for caregivers for almost every veteran around, but not for the Vietnam-era veterans. So this bill, the Mission Act, applies the VA caregiver benefits to all veterans. So if a veteran needs that assistance, that same incentive to help with a stipend for that service is available to that veteran. That is a giant step forward for all of us. It's very important to also recognize that we consolidate the VA's 7 community care funding sources into one single community care source. So for the first time in 3 years, the VA will no longer announce every 3 months they're running out of money. They use that little trick on us a lot of times because they run out of money in one stove department, but they had 6 others that were loaded. So we've merged them all together to see to it all the funds are available and accessible all the time for the veterans that have the need for the benefit. No more crying fire in a crowded theater. No more scaring us all that we're not funding our veterans, but instead seeing to it our veterans have access and that it's timely and when they need it. That's a very important change, and that's a move forward that we needed to make for a long, long time. It makes sense for us to make sure that our veterans have their choice based on quality and access and timeliness. It makes sense that we make that a key part of the veterans' benefits to all veterans. It makes sense that we see to it that caregiver benefits are available at Vietnam veterans as well as many others. See, it makes sense that we do all the other things that we've done, all the VA acts to come together with a totally reformed Veterans Administration for our veterans who served us. How many people is that? That's 22.5 million people in America today that served us at one time or another. 6.5 million who are served by the VA Health Services. That's a lot of people, but it's a small handful of people compared to the 350 million people in our country. Think about this, less than 1% of our population served and defended us all and risked their lives. So when you go to vote next on this bill today, think about the veteran in your state, the VA service in your state, the people in your state. Think about what you remember about World War I and II, and what you remember about Vietnam, and what you remember about Iraqi freedom and Afghanistan. Think about what you think you owe to those that signed on the bottom line. They weren't conscripted, they weren't mandated, they volunteered, and they went and they fought and they died. I want to leave you with a thought on 2 of those veterans, because they're the 2 faces I see every day as chairman of this committee that I'm working for. One of them is Noah Harris. Noah was a cheerleader at the University of Georgia on 9/11/2001 when he watched like you and I did on television and saw Al-Qaeda and the evils of that era take down the Twin Towers and have the first battle of the ultimate war between good and evil. We fought that battle. We're still winning it. We're still fighting it. We will fight it for a long time. We've lost over 6,000 lives of individuals who sacrificed their life in Iraq or Afghanistan or other places in the Middle East. And there will be others to come. They've sacrificed so you and I can do what we're doing here today. The First Amendment protections of speaking our mind as I'm doing, the right to assemble as our constituents do, the right to defend ourselves and be safe. All those God-given rights we have were written on paper, but they were given life and protection to all of us by the veterans who volunteered, who fought, and who died. And so I remember Noah Harris because he was a cheerleader one day at the University of Georgia. And on 9/12/2001, the day after 9/11, he went down to the Armory, signed up for OCS, went in the Army, became an officer, and 2 years later, almost to the day, died in Ghazaria in Baghdad, the victim of an IED. He died defending the country that he loved so much. He cheered for the football team, but he fought and sacrificed his life for the country. And to Lucy and Rick, his dad, today in LJ, Georgia, I want them to know I haven't forgotten Noah and what he did for us. And I signed most of my notes the same way Noah signed his note with me. IDWIC, Noah Harrison. IDWIC stood for I Do What I Can. Well, I'm going to have the chance to do what I can today, and I'm going to vote for this bill for all the right reasons, but principally for Noah Harris. And the other one's for a veteran whose name is Roy C. Irwin. Roy C. Irwin died in the Battle of the Bulge in the Netherlands in 1944. When I went to the cemetery in Margraten, Netherlands to visit the grave sites there and check on the American Battle Monument, I walked with my wife down the row of crosses and Stars of David just to pause for a second and give thanks for what the over 800 soldiers buried there in that cemetery did in the Battle of Bulge to make our lives possible and for me to enjoy the benefits that I've enjoyed. We got to the end of row 23 and I looked down and there was a cross. It said, Roy C. Irwin, New Jersey, private, December 28th, 1944, KIA, killed in action. I froze at that because I was born on December 28th in 1944. The day Roy C. Irwin from New Jersey died in the Battle of the Bulge, my mother delivered me in Piedmont Hospital. I'm almost 74 years old. I've had those wonderful 74 years, including the opportunity to serve in the United States Senate, because I never knew when he was 18 years old, volunteered to go to fight in the Battle of the Bulge and in the Army for the United States of America. Paid the ultimate sacrifice. And so he did, I got the ultimate benefit. So when you think about your vote today on this bill, you think about all those veterans who did the same for you, who have the same birthday or the same killed in action date as you had birthday, and recognize that every one of us stand on the shoulders of our veterans, live and work and pray on the shoulders of our veterans. And I, for one, am going to vote for our veterans when we pass this bill so the VA Mission Act becomes the final mosaic and a beautiful patchwork of benefits for those who have sacrificed the most for all of us.